Hi, ladies and gentlemen, it's Empress Arlana. I would like to thank you, everyone, not only here in Brampton, but over in Miami, Florida, you know, down south. I appreciate your support. Anyone in the USA logging on, I always appreciate when you pass through my channel. Don't forget, it's free to subscribe. Click on the subscribe button below, and I'm very happy that you're here, and I'm very happy that you took time to listen. Today is not about ranting or raving. It's not a complaint. I am not making a negative statement. I am addressing a concern. It's a concern that was derived from a conversation that I had with an individual who's a musician. And the musician was trying to figure out how to understand the work-life balance in Canada, how to maintain a career as a musician while having a regular job and steady employment in Canada, how to balance the two and how to maintain the same lifestyle. Ironically, in the island or in other parts of the world, it might seem a little easier to live according to the way in which a musician desires. The world has changed, the economy has changed. I constantly preach this statement in every video that I make. It's important to recognize that when you have multiple hats and you have multiple skills, you can wear those hats and you can use those skills to your advantage so that when the time comes for performing or going on tour, you have the flexibility to do so. And I'm a 70s baby. Back in the 70s, at that time, I was not applying for any work, obviously. I was growing up. It's important to mention that back then, it was different. There were no online applications or computerized forms or webcam interviews or cyber interviews or forms that make you click the check mark to say, yes, you agree to the disclosure of information to run a credit check on you, a background check on you all at once at the same time of your application. These processes were not in place back then. It was more of a casual walk-in, face-to-face, in-person, hi, are you looking for someone? I'm here to help. Back then, it might have been easier for a musician to easily acquire a job that fits flexibly around one's schedule to be able to go on tour and to travel and play at leisure, regardless of the instrument or the genre of music. This video is not only about music. Okay, this video is also about life. Sometimes it's not that someone deliberately chose to stay in a dead-end job. It's not that someone deliberately wants to work part-time, contracts, constant projects, because a lot of these jobs are now project-based. And when you have an opportunity that presents itself and it brings income to your household to take care of your husband and your stepchildren and your family matters, you take it. Even if it means you have to juggle the other hats at the same time, it leaves doors open so that when one door closes, another one will always be open. Have you ever been laid off? Do you know what it feels to have been working for 60 grand a year and then all of a sudden you wake up one morning, you go to work, everything's normal. You stop at Timmy's, you get your chamomile tea. And then when you arrive at work, all of a sudden everyone's crying. You know, men who you've seen looking like the strongest men in the workplace, they're on their knees in tears. And everyone is getting laid off, including yourself. And what about when you go for another job again and you think, oh, it's smooth sailing. You get stability. You're maintaining a stable lifestyle for about a year. And then, boom, another layoff again. And here you go. You're back on the search. It happens to the best of us, regardless of educational status or class or race. It can happen. So a person made a comment that the person wondered why one would choose the type of work or the type of job in which one is working. As many of you might know, I'm a part-time teacher in French. I'm a PSW, that's personal support worker, assisting seniors and those living with disabilities in the long-term care facilities. So I've worked in healthcare as well as security. I've worked in healthcare security, I've worked in event security, and assisting with voluntary programs alongside the police departments. On the side of all of that, I'm a journalist, freelance. Yes, I get paid to write for newspapers. I'm a social media marketing person. I'm an advertising agent, a booking agent, and an entertainment booking specialist, a manager of every program that I've ever created online. Yes, I wear a few hats. I love dog training and dog sitting and pet care. The list goes on. You want to talk about horseback riding? I've done that too. The point of the matter is that you should never limit yourself. You should never put yourself in a box. You should never pigeonhole yourself. Yes, it is important to choose a job that is long-term. Choose a job that will maintain stability, that will help you to contribute to the Canadian pension plan that seems to be running out as time goes on, that may not be around later. It's important to maintain an income as steady and as normal as it may seem, even though it might not be the best job. It's important to have a job so that when employers look at your resume, they can see you're not just sitting on your you're actually trying to work. You're trying to adopt some type of lifestyle in which you're volunteering or working in internships, apprenticeships. You are staying busy. You are staying occupied. Stability is very important. So even if it's not the job of your dreams or the career of your dreams, it's important that you're contributing toward the CPP for the future so that when that time comes, you do have enough to live on. If you should live that long, but just plan in case you do. There's nothing wrong with planning. If we fail to plan, we plan to fail. You can always leave the job. You can always retire early. You can always juggle between the other two that you have. There's nothing wrong with that. As long as you have multiple streams of income on which your family can depend. If you're a woman like myself, you wouldn't want your husband to be the only breadwinner. You want to equally contribute to the household, so that he's not carrying the full load all the time. And it's a heavy load sometimes. I think it's important for everyone to understand that there's nothing wrong with choosing stability. There's nothing wrong with choosing to hold on to a steady job while you're searching in the meantime. Rather than being unemployed and having nothing, it's better to have something than nothing. So don't feel guilty. Don't feel guilty that you have a master's degree or your PhD and somehow you found yourself in a marginalized, borderline type of job, dead-end type of job. It's just temporary. It's just like getting on the bus and getting off. You're just getting off at the next stop rather than standing outside in the cold, waiting for the next bus to pass by that will take you to your destination. Just get on a bus and start riding. There's nothing wrong with that. Don't let anyone ever make you feel as if you're a failure for doing that. Your education is inside here. No one will take that from you, and no one will judge you because of the type of work that you do. And if you so choose to have many different skill sets and you're a jack of all trades or a Jane of all trades, so be it. Just keep mastering your talents and your skills. Getting back to the conversation at hand, I was trying to convince the musician that the type of choice one makes is a choice for survival. And it's necessary. You may not be able to go on vacations every year. You may not be able to fly out in a moment's notice except for a funeral, God forbid, if that should be the case, unfortunately, and regrettably so. Sometimes we have to choose that. But if you're unable to fly away when you want to, it doesn't mean that you will never fly. It just means that not yet. You're not yet ready to fly, but you will. There will be a day when you can. And it's important that when you get back, you still have a roof over the heads of your children, your stepchildren, your husband, your dogs, your life. You still have a roof over your head and food on the table. Don't compromise for anyone. Always have a plan. How are you going to make ends meet after you've spent all this money? Put aside your money, save your money, and your money will save you. But if you haven't put aside for a rainy day and you don't have savings, you really have to think twice before you make that trip. And yes, it's a choice to hold on to a job that doesn't end. It might be, well, not the best paying job, but it makes ends meet and It's ongoing. Some people end up leaving jobs because of the pay, but if in the long run, it gives you stability and ongoing income, it's a job to hold on to, because in this day and age, most of the jobs are contract-based. Contractual work that ends, it always has an end date. It's always temporary, temporary, temporary. And when you're faced with an end date, you have to get back to the grinding again, get back to the searching again, and it's a constant search that never ends. So yes, people hold on to dead-end, deadbeat jobs because it pays the bills and it helps people to work toward their bigger dreams, to continue to self-educate, to continue to take upgrades and courses and training and to live a better life. Do what you have to do and do you. In the words of a very, very famous person, do you. CMF. That's a quote that I received. Enjoy the day. It's a happy one. Arlana.com, CultureTalkTV.com, Empress Talk Radio FM, all on YouTube. Email me, Arlana@Arlana.com, TheJobHunterLady.com, and I'm here for you, and I understand what you're going through. And remember, I'm broadcasting live and direct from the Arlana TV Network, all on YouTube.com/ArlanaTV. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button. It's free. I'll see you soon.